Men must be prepared to return to battle, Nassau. There's no way back to join a fight to resist a British incursion.
If you want them to fear you, it shouldn't be you delivering the message. The message I understand, but I think someone else needs to deliver it.
Someone? Who?
Him.
I understand this is the place cowards come to beg forgiveness from a king. Every last rotten fuck on this island has crossed a man far less forgiving than old George will ever be. But when we set sail, I will keep the list of names remaining. Those men will not be forgotten. And I assure you, those men will hear from us again.
Questioning what kind of man you are if you don't see retribution for the offense.
Tomorrow you will join us. Or you will all be looking over your shoulders the rest of your lives.
You may be concerned that someday we will clash. Worried that though today we be friends, someday you will have no choice but to be my enemy.
That's all he wanted in exchange for Max. me to sit still. But he warned me that your commitment to the greatest possible victory in this war of ours would consume her and eventually lead to her death. That's nothing for him to say if his intent is to split us apart. I suppose we should have expected nothing less.
You're either going to have to concede and let him have his way, or you're going to have to kill him.
Because there is something in the air between you and your friend up there.
Are you a fucking coward?
Lisa. I'm just the cook.
This is not what I wanted. But I will stand here with you. For an hour. A day, a year. Will you find a way to accept this outcome?
Long John Silver's story is a hard one to know. And those who stood to benefit most from it were the most eager to leave it all behind. Until all that remains of any of it are stories.
Until then, I remain Long John Silver.
My name is John Silver, and I've got a long fucking memory.